Hey guys, so this problem is going to focus on a word problem that deals with rational expressions that really honestly is kind of just one of the simpler examples here because really it's just dealing with proportions. Remember that rational expressions is just anything in polynomial form that can be written as a fraction. But fractions can look all sorts of different ways. There's so many different examples that we have that deal with fractions. And that we also need to keep in mind that if we're talking about proportions, proportions are technically rational expressions because proportions are written in fraction form. So before I get too far ahead of myself, let's read through this problem so that we can figure out what's going on with this specific problem and how are we going to solve it. So taking a look at this problem here, this says, in math class, 5 out of every 7 students are girls. So if we have a total of 70 students in the class, how many are girls? And then how many are boys? So we're trying to figure out if we have a 5 out of 7 ratio of girls to boys, and we have 70 students in the class, well, how many would be girls and how many would be boys? So this here, we're going to focus on writing a proportion in order to solve this example here. Starting with the ratio that we know. When you're setting up a proportion, always start with the ratio that you know, the given information. We're told that 5 out of 7 students are girls. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna say, hey, 5 out of 7, 5 over 7 are girls. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna set this equal to the ratio that we're actually going to solve for. So remember that this 5 stands for how many girls we have, and the 7 is the total. We have 5 girls out of a total of 7 students. And this is important because when we're trying to write the ratio that we're solving for, we need to make sure that that is set up exactly the same way as our other ratio. As if our original ratio over here on the left is girls to the total, the ratio over here on the right also has to be girls to total. Now, pay attention to the question they ask. They say, if there are 70 students in the class, how many are girls? So we're trying to solve for how many girls there are in total. So our numerator up here, that's what we're solving for. We're solving for the number of girls. So we're gonna label that as an X. The denominator, which is supposed to represent the total, they give that to us. They say that there's a total of 70 students. So 5 is to 7 as X is to 70. So this is our setup for this problem. And in my opinion, honestly, setting up this proportion here from the beginning is probably the most important part of the problem because we need to be able to understand how to read this and set up a proper equation for it. Because if we set it up incorrectly, we can do our math correctly all day long, but we would be solving the wrong problem. So we need to make sure that we understand the problem and that we're setting up correctly from the beginning. Now that we have this proportion set up, in order to solve a proportion, you cross multiply. So when you cross multiply, you do this. Literally, it's the one where you make an X. Right, 5 times 70. So we're gonna do 5 times 70. So let's see, 5 times 70 is 350. And that's going to equal to 7 times X, which is 7X. So this is our equation here, 350 equals to 7X. So this is a one-step equation to solve. The only thing we need to do is divide out the coefficient. Remember that this is 7 times X. The opposite of multiplication is division. So we're gonna divide both sides by 7. On the right-hand side, it's gonna cancel, and we're gonna be left with X is equal to 50. What that represents is that if we had a class of 70 students, 50 of them would be girls. But go back up to our question here because we had a second part to it. It not only said how many are girls, but it also said how many are boys. So if 50 out of 70 students are girls, the leftover has to be boys, right? So 70 minus 50 is gonna give us 20. So if we have 50 girls, then we have 20 boys. Right? So a 50 to 20 ratio, girls completely wins out of the boys, more girls than boys. So hey, but that is how we will solve this problem here, setting up a proportion and then making sure that we cross multiply in order to solve it.